Hi, Jody.
Hi, Tanya. How are you?
Good. How are you?
So good.
Good. I'm so glad to see you.
You too. How's your summer going?
It's kind of weird. Like,
no, weird. That's a good description of it.
Yeah. Like the things we normally do with my kids, we're just like no library, no pool. So we're just kind of like, they're playing so many video games and I've just kind of tried to like let my guilt go about it. Cause I'm just like,
yeah,
it's okay.
Mine are playing a lot too. like, but it's going to be fine.
Yeah, they'll be fine. So other than that, it's going great.
Yeah. Good.
How about you?
We finally have hot weather. I'm kind of liking this warm weather.
Yeah, I like the sun. So,
yeah.
Yeah. Well, thanks for agreeing to do this.
Yes.
You could have charged me lots of money to do this. So I appreciate it.
I'm happy to. Yeah. Thanks for having me.
So I guess for those who are going to be watching this later, who might not know who you are, I'll just introduce you, I guess.
Okay.
Cool. So Jody is a life coach, a master certified life coach, right? And she has a business called Jody Moore Coaching with a monthly program called Be Bold. And I'm a part of that. It's really great. And I think I actually heard of you first on the Life Coach School podcast.
Oh, uh-huh.
That's where I first heard you being interviewed and then found out you live nearby me, and I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. small world. So yeah, I've been in Jody's coaching program and she's one of my clients, so I've photographed her. And actually recently we did a photo session, and I, through the years of photographing women, I've just learned they ask for certain things in the retouching. Yes. So I just automatically do them, you know, like most people want lines around their eyes removed and their hair smoothed out and maybe their arms like thinned or something like that. So I just automatically do it. And so Jody surprised me by emailing me back and saying, hey, can you like add my wrinkles back in? And I was like, oh, I love you so much. just because I like when I photograph people, I see how they are and I love how they are, you know, I see it and I just feel like, you know, there's character in your face from those lines and you earned them through the years of living that you've had. And so it's always kind of broken my heart when a woman especially looks at her photos and like lists all of these things that she hates about how she looks. But through the years, I've just kind of gotten used to it and been like, well, I want you to love your photos, so we'll change it. But I would love it more if they just loved how they looked in their photos. Yes. As they are. So.
And it's work I still have to do too. I mean, I think about even like, why do I put on makeup? Why do I like, why don't I just love my face? You know? So I think that we all have different levels of it. And I don't think it's anything, you know, for anybody listening to this to feel bad about if you have all of that, you know, noise that comes up, that chatter in our heads. I still have it too. But it is something I work on a lot. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the reasons why is I, you know, a few years ago, remember seeing a picture of myself from probably 10 years before that. And I remember, you know, 10 years ago when that picture was first taken, thinking, oh, I look so overweight and like being so critical and judgmental of myself, right? Mm-hmm. And then 10 years later, seeing the photo and going, I looked so good there.
Right.
Like, I was thinner there and I didn't have the wrinkles. And like, why didn't I just think that I looked amazing? Because looking at it now, right, having aged a little and all of that. And so it really made me realize like, oh my goodness, like, first of all, not that like, oh, it's only going to get worse, but just, it really is just my brain. It is just our brains.
Right.
Like beauty and all of that is just a story. And I don't want to go the rest of my life loathing myself and being someone who has a business where I need to have a lot of pictures taken of myself and I'm sort of the face of my business. I just was like, that's enough of that.
Right.
Like, we're not going to walk around judgmental and critical. There's no upside to that. And so I started working on just accepting the way I looked and choosing to love me.
Yeah. That's great. So, yeah. That's the one thing I try to tell my clients, you know, like, is the way you look in these photos going to affect the way you're able to help your clients get a result with what you're offering them? Like, likely not, right? It just doesn't matter.
That's right.
Yeah. And I've tried to tell myself that too, because I, you know, I've started to put myself in front of the camera more, and I look at the pictures and I'm like, I used to be so much thinner and I don't like the way I look, but I just remind myself that, like, it doesn't matter. Nobody cares how much I weigh.
Right.
It's not going to affect how I can take pictures of them.
They want to know if you can take good pictures.
Yeah.
And that's true with all of us in our businesses.
Right.
Like, even people that maybe have like a beauty business or a weight loss business or whatever, still your client cares about, can you help me get the results I want to get? Mm-hmm. And that really helps me when I redirect my head to, like, this isn't about you. Even though I'm the face of the business and it's my name and all that, I still know it's not about me. I just, you know, am the vehicle by which I'm bringing hopefully some helpful tools to people. And so they associate me with it, but it's really not about me. It's always about them. And that helps me, like, you know, shift my head. The other thing is I just made the decision several years ago that I was going to decide to like myself in pictures. The same way I think my babies look adorable in any picture.
Right.
Right. I never be like, oh, well, he's kind of making a funny face, or he looks chubby in that one.
Right.
Just like, he's so cute. Look at him. And like, look at that silly face. And look how funny it is that we happen to click the camera right when he was making that face. Like, we're at least amused by it. We don't do the self-loathing thing.
Yeah.
And I was like, that is available to me. I could just decide to like the way I look no matter what, and to just love me the way I love my child. It's really not even about the look, right? It's about all the things I love about them. That's why I love that picture of them. And so doing that work on loving me, all of me, and then just choosing to, even if it's a picture where I made a weird face, I'm not going to use it on my Facebook ad. But I'm still going to be like, that's the face I was making right there.
I
make that face sometimes. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I love that attitude, because I find some women, I send them their proofs or whatever, and they can't even get past the emotions of how much they hate they look to choose the good photos, right? Like, they're like so emotional and like, oh my gosh, I just spent all this money and I hate the way I look in the pictures. And I'm like, wait a minute here. Like, we took 800 pictures. We need 10. Like, surely there's 10 in here that look amazing.
And I think that's so important too, that you're talking about this, Tanya, because you get the 800, and even though probably only 10 of them are great.
Yeah.
Which would be true if you were like Angelina Jolie or average stay-at-home mom. Like, 10 of the 800, that's what we're trying to get. We expect that 790 are not going to be good. That's okay. It doesn't. So all the self-loathing, I think it's important to, I have to remind myself that, like, of course, like, there's, that's why you are so brilliant at taking so many, so that we can pick out the gems.
Right.
But you know, like, it's just the nature of trying to capture a still image of a dynamic thing.
Right.
Person in this case, you know, is that, you know, 90% of them, of course, are not going to be good.
Right. And that's why I think the retouching still has a place too, because we aren't still people. You know, we have, people don't notice every line on our face when we're talking, because they're looking at our whole person. So I still feel like in advertising, it's okay to do some retouching if you feel like it's distracting. You know, it's okay to remove stuff from the background, or if, you know, there was a bulge in the fabric or something, like, or even removing shadows under your eyes. I think it's totally fine. But if you can go into it with that attitude of, I'm going to love myself no matter what.
and we're just going to be objective.
Yeah. Like, I'm picking a photo for my ad. Like, what's going to be the best one? And, you know, it doesn't really matter if, you know, my hair was out of place a little bit, or I can fix it in Photoshop.
Yeah.
But
totally. And I even think if somebody wants you to Photoshop out their wrinkles a little bit, I don't think that's a problem in and of itself.
Right.
Where I sometimes go is like the pictures that we took together, I was like, that doesn't really look like me.
Right. And we want it to look like
it wasn't like I said, remove all editing. I was like, I like how you fix the lighting and if my hair is out of place or whatever. But like, I know when I look at it that my eyes look, they have more lines and I want it to still look like me. And, you know, so again, I'm not opposed to retouching or editing at all, but just, I guess asking why, right? Like if we're really working on loving ourselves, which I think is important, and especially if you have a service-based business, like for me as a coach, I'm trying to help my clients be more confident. Yeah. I have to be doing that work too.
Right.
On my own self. So.
Yeah. Well, I think too, talking about the age, like looking back 10 years, I mean, we've all been 20, but we're not 20 now, you know, and it's okay to not look 20 when you're 40.
That's right.
So, you know, and I wish our society placed more like on age and wisdom, you know, like more value on that. And I think we can work on that and within ourselves and with our own, you know, what we project to our daughters and stuff like that. Like, it's amazing that you lived to be 40. Like, some people didn't get to live that long, you know? So, and it's okay to show that we have that age, and you know, 40, 50, 60 and beyond. I think it's exciting what women are doing now, at those ages, in the business world. It's pretty cool what we can
really
do.
Really,
and that I get to photograph those women doing those amazing things. And I would love for them to be able to go into their photo shoot confident and just knowing that they're going to love their photos no matter what. So if someone go ahead.
Oh, sorry. I was just going to say, when you say we all used to be 20, as much as I would love 20-year-old skin, I don't really want much of the other stuff that comes with being 20. Like, I'll say 45. So anyway.
Yeah. So I think, that's been a thought for me to think of, like, I'm glad I'm not 20 right now.
Right.
But for someone who hasn't really done any mindset work, like, what would be a first step for them to move toward, you know, changing their thoughts or even just observing their thoughts about this? Because I think we don't really necessarily, if we haven't done this work, we don't think about this as being a conscious choice that we have, how we think about it.
That's right. Well, I think that is one of the first steps, is knowing that it is a conscious choice, because it doesn't feel like a conscious choice. Mm-hmm. It just feels like I don't like them. Mm-hmm. I look at them and I notice I don't like them, but it is a choice. And I really recommend that you make the decision ahead of time, and you don't have to go all the way to, I'm just going to love what I see there, but just decide I'm not going to be so hard on myself.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm going to be compassionate with myself. No matter what I see, I'm going to choose kindness at least, right? Like, we have the ability as human beings to do that. We do this with other people in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes also what helps me is I try to look at myself. If I'm having a lot of judgment or criticism at some point, I try to imagine like that I'm someone else who I respect and adore.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I immediately think of someone like Brene Brown, who I just think is brilliant, and I respect her, and I think she's fun to listen to and all that. I'm like, okay, if I'm looking at a photo of Brene Brown, my thoughts are not like, she's gained a little weight and she has more wrinkles. That's not even really relevant.
Right.
What's more relevant to me is like all the wisdom that she shares and how she's really kind of, funny to listen to. And, her appearance is like very secondary to everything else I love about her. And so I try to remind myself, like, if I can't get to like, I like how I look, I can at least be like, that's not really relevant here. Like,
I'm
just trying to help people. And it sort of helps me to like view myself from the outside, like I'm another person. And I know I have clients that view me that way, that they love what they've learned from me. And in my appearance is secondary to all of that. And so I try to like, you know, if I'm looking at someone else, how would I think about this? So
yeah, those are some good thoughts. Right. Yeah. I think another thing too is, like you mentioned, makeup and stuff. I think if you've shown up having done your best to look your best, you know, and trusting your photographer that they're going to make you look your best. And then just, you know, I notice photographing men, they don't have these thoughts. Like, they're like, I look awesome. Like, or that's how I look. Can't change it. Like, you know.
That one works for me, actually, sometimes. I'm just like, well, that's how I look. Yeah. It is. It's so interesting how it's such a dominantly female thing, right?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, maybe men feel insecure, but they don't tell me about it. You know, yeah. I mean, I joke sometimes, if you were a spy and you wanted to find out a woman's insecurity, like, have a photo shoot with her, because she would tell you everything she does about herself. Like, and I just listen. I just, like, let them offload it onto me, and I listen, and I don't judge, and I just, you know, like, it's okay.
Yeah, that's hilarious. Yeah, you have to hold space for that a lot.
Yeah, yeah. So, half the time I want to just be like, oh, I disagree. I think you look amazing. You know, and going to the age thing too. If I'm photographing someone who's 60, I'm like, man, I hope I look that good in 20 years.
Yeah, right?
But they're thinking, oh man, do I really look this old? And, you know, I'm just like, well, I think you look great. So it's hard for me. I used to take it personally when people didn't like their photos. But I've learned to be like, okay, that's your thought about your photo and yourself.
Yes.
And try to help you change it a little
bit.
That's right. Thankfully, I've learned that and didn't give up a long time ago.
Yeah, yeah, that's right. One other thing I was going to mention that might be useful to people is I started doing this work on my thoughts about my photos just in my casual everyday life, you mm-hmm. know, like when you are taking a family photo or you take a selfie with a friend. And I just decided, you know how everybody's like, let me see it. Oh no, let's do it again. Like we have to see it and decide if we want to retake. And I just decided I'm not going to do that. And especially I'll do live events and I would take selfies with people. You know,
yep.
And I was like, we're not going to redo selfies.
Yeah.
We don't have time for that. So I just decided, no matter what I look like, I'm going to choose, like you said, that's what I looked like in that moment. So, so whenever I take a selfie with a friend and they're like, let's look at it. I always say, I love it. Now, sometimes in my head, I may not be thinking that, but I just choose to go, I love it. We look great. No, that's how we looked right then. Yeah. We're not retaking that moment. And so you can practice kind of just in your everyday life, you know, your more casual photos. Mm-hmm.
That's
choosing
a good tip.
To love it.
Right. Yeah. And you can watch your kids too. Like, kids love to see pictures of themselves. I'm always fascinated by this. You know, they're like, take my picture. Can I see the picture? And they love it no matter what.
They never say, can we do a retake?
Yeah. Yeah. And I'm wondering, like, where does that change? Like, at what point do we decide that we don't look good?
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm always wondering.
It's a fascinating question. It really is. And you're right. It's like, I feel like it's the same age when we stop coming to the lunch table in our swimsuit and we just all of a sudden become aware that people are judging us and there's a right way to look and a right way to be. And it's sad that we get that, but it's available to us.
Yeah.
To just love it.
Right. Yeah. So if somebody wanted to get like coaching on this, where would they go for you to help them?
I've actually coached on this exact thing even before, but I, like you said, best place would be my monthly coaching program, Be Bold. So you can just go to jodymoore.com and click on Be Bold program to learn more about that. But we coach on everything. And I do think it's a deeper issue of just overall self-love. Like if I respected and adored myself, like I respect and adore Brené Brown, I wouldn't be so critical of my appearance, but it is also a natural, normal thing. So we can improve it. It might never go away, but we can certainly get a handle on it. And so that would be in Be Bold. Yeah.
Right. And do you feel like over time, as you've gotten your photo taken a lot, do you feel more comfortable and you're just kind of like, whatever now? Like, or do you still feel like you go
easier than it was?
Yeah.
It's sort of like I do a podcast. So I hear my voice, you know, when you first hear your voice, you're not used to it. It sounds weird and it's very vulnerable. And when you first see yourself on video, if you're not used to that, then you sort of get used to like, oh yeah, that's how I sound. Oh yeah, I do play with my hair a lot. Like that's me. So I do think it's gotten easier. I still just have to like, you know, I get the 200 photos and immediately I'm like, what? Oh, there's a good one. And I have to remind myself,
right.
only a small percentage of these are going to be ones I want to keep, and that's mm-hmm. okay.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Perfect.
Fun work.
I know, right? Oh my goodness. Yeah. Well, is there anything else, any other tips you would share, or anything you want to, any programs you have coming up? You want, I mean, this is going to be like on my blog, so it'll be.
Yeah. It, I mean,
but
yeah, all the things I offer in my monthly program are pretty, you know, the people can go there to learn more about it. Mm-hmm. I'm constantly adding to it, but no, I mean, the only other thing is I just love that you're offering this to your clients. I think it's one of those things that I've never had a photographer talk about this before. Mm-hmm. And I think it is so important. And what's crazy is we think if we look good in the picture, we're going to be more confident.
Right.
But it goes the opposite.
Yes.
The more confident you are going in, the better you're going to look in that photo.
Yes, totally. Yes. In fact,
crazy.
Some of my favorite clients weren't necessarily the most pretty, like from the world standards, but they were right. confident and they believed yes. in themselves, and we had the most fun, and you know, it was not stressful, and they loved all their pictures. So that is so true. If you can go yes. in with confidence before, even if you internally kind of feel like, well, I don't know if I'm going to like my pictures, if you can somehow muster up that confidence right. on the day of and just keep those thoughts in your head, like, I'm amazing. I'm doing this for my clients. Yeah. I know right. I'm going to have good pictures.
Then, or step into like your alter ego, like Beyonce used to right. do going on stage. You'd like have your role model that you admire and just be her for that photo shoot.
Right, right.
Even if it's a little bit pretend, like step into some pretend confidence even. Mm-hmm. Ironically enough, like your pictures better. It's
yep.
magic.
Yeah, no, that's a really good tip too. So it's yeah. totally true. I've totally seen that. And I wonder if that's why the men seem to be easier to photograph as well, because just they think they're amazing. So we should think like men when we go into our photo shoot.
You should in that way. You're allowed
yeah.
to. You're
yeah.
allowed to just think, I've got it going on. Let's go. Take my picture.
yeah. All right. Well, thank you, Jody.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, thanks so much for sharing. I really appreciate your coaching. I'm listening in weekly to your podcast and life coaching calls and have gotten so much
oh, nice.
Out of it. And I think you're coaching my business coach too, Neil oh. Williams.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
So I'm inadvertently getting influence from, from nice. There as well. So.
Neil's great. Yeah. I know.
Yeah. Yeah. Like she's her. Really great. So.
Yeah. Fun.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay.
All right. Well, thanks, Tanya.
Yeah. Thank you. And I'll be in touch and I'll okay. let you know when this is up on my blog. If you want to share it okay, with anyone cool. too, that would be great. So
I'd love to. All right, cool.
Thank okay, you
so
thanks.
Much. Have a good Bye. One. Bye.